Hey guys, welcome to part one of my Necromancer series. First off, we'll be looking at all the ARPG games that best cover necromancy. Now, what I'll be comparing the games in my list to is this old game, Diablo 2. In my opinion, of all the ARPGs, it's very hard to beat the Necromancer from Diablo 2. It's extremely good. You get many minions, they're all very capable, and you get lots of them. You can get multiple skeleton warriors. I don't know what the exact limit is, but at least six. Then you can get the same amount of skeletal mages. Then you can get golems, different kinds. And yeah, it's a very satisfying necromancy experience that no one until recent times has really even tried to replicate. Luckily, we've got some new games to take a look at which try and do a necromancer, and in my opinion, they do it quite well. In order for me to consider a necromancy game for this list, it has to fulfill the following criteria. Minions must be plentiful. You can't feel like a powerful necromancer if you've only got a handful of minions, so you need to have at least a decent squad or an army of them. Second of all, minions have to be permanent. I really hate it in games when minions only last about 10 seconds, you have to resummon them. That's just really fucked up. Third, minions must be useful. There's nothing worse in the game, aside from a timed minion that only lasts about 10 seconds, than a minion that's weak and just falls over after one hit. They have to be able to carry a battle. Your minions also have to be stronger than you are. I think a lot of the problems that people have with balancing minion builds in games comes from the fact that they don't weaken the caster. The summoner has to be weak and the minions have to be strong. The minions have to be sort of both the sword and the shield of the caster, and without them, he's supposed to be weak and kind of helpless. Finally, as a bonus, the minion should be craftable in some way. That can be just summoning them from a corpse, or otherwise building them from bones and stuff like that. This isn't essential, this is just kind of like a bonus criteria that just adds to the coolness factor. Alright, so the first game I'd like to look at is Grim Dawn. In my opinion, Grim Dawn comes the closest to the original Diablo II Necromancer of the modern ARPGs. You can get skeletons like this, and once fully maxed out, you get a maximum of 8 skeletons, and they're of different types. For example, the mage skeleton, knight skeleton, and also little naked skeletons, which are very fast, and you've got the crossbowmen as well. Aside from these skeletons, you also get a Blight Fiend like this. And the Blight Fiend is sort of almost like a tank spellcaster minion, and kind of fulfills a similar role to the Golem in Diablo 2. There's one of those naked skeletons I was talking about. If you multi-class, because this game allows you to multi-class with one of the other classes available, you can get, like, if you go for a cultist like I did here, you get the summons from the cultist as well. For example, this hell spawn dog thing, and also this raven, which brings you to a total of about 11 permanent minions, which is pretty good. You can give these guys direct commands in battle as well, like head attack. They go running forth to attack something. As you can see, the minions are capable, holding their own in combat. None of this stupid bullshit like a minion only lasts for 10 seconds and dies with one hit. None of that bullshit in this game. Your minions are very capable. Aside from the permanent minions which you get, which is like the skeletons, Blight Fiend, and the other two I mentioned, there's also temporary minions. For example, there's this Reap Spirit ability which deals a significant amount of aether damage and also makes a temporary wraith, which is really neat. I think you can get at least three of these. I'm not sure what the hard limit is. Let's go find out. There's one. See if we can make any more. At least two, I think. Let's try again. Didn't last very long. I think they're unlimited, it's just that you'll never get that many of them due to them despawning. You see that little thing that was crawling along just there? That was a summon granted by my items, I believe. I think I've got an item here. Yeah. See this mace, the scepter? It allows me a chance on enemy death to spawn one of those things. So the game also features temporary summons, which is kind of cool. So depending on what your equipment is, you can get, you know, a variety of different temporary summons going for you. So it's possible to have quite the army. I do have another temporary summon here I'd like to show you. But it's got a rarer chance of spawning. Let's see if I can trigger it. There it is. That thing. That, sort of puke colored dog thing. It's called a Rift Spawn. And that thing is granted by it's sort of like a passive trigger. And it comes from my devotions. Can't remember which one exactly. Yeah, it's this one. Bismal's Command, 20% chance on attack that I spawn one of these things. So that's just yet another temporary minion you can get. Overall, the minion experience in this game is very satisfying in my opinion. Your minions are strong, they last well, and you really need them. Like, if you go for a minion build, you can't not have your minions out, you'll end up dead. So all in all, I really love Grim Dawn. Alright, now the next game worth covering is Path of Exile. It's got a very complicated skill tree, and if you configure it just right, you can get some really decent minions and stuff. It's all kinds of stuff, like you know, for increasing the amount of zombies and skeletons you can have and just tweaking them. Like, for example, you can get an ability somewhere here that lets them explode on death. Yeah, this one. So when your minions die, they explode. What else have we got? Increased life. Nah, just all kinds of tweaks you can do. And you can also later unlock the Necromancer class. Which is almost like a prestige class. And it's got some more unique buffs and abilities for your minions. But let's talk about the minions you can get. So, you have permanent minions, which are like these zombies here. If I can figure out how to cast them. What the fuck's going on here? Raise zombie. No? Can't even play, guys. What the fuck's going on? Can't even play a game. Why am I too stupid to play this? I've got Q for the fucking skull. W for the skeleton, R for the fucking shit, and T? Alright, I need a corpse. Fuck. Duh. So I'm gonna have to kill some shit. To do that, I'm gonna spam these temporary skeletons and these flying skulls. These skeletons only hang around for maybe 30 seconds or so. And they aren't very mobile, they just sort of sit where they are. But you can make a lot of them and they're pretty useful. Because now that we've got some corpses, let's make some permanent minions like these zombies. So now that I've got some corpses, I can finally cast this. Once you fully skill it up, you can get about 8 zombies. Yeah, max of 8. Maybe if you go back to your skill tree, you can find something in here which raises it even further. I'm not entirely sure. I did my best to take all the ones which increase the minion limit. But it's a pretty big tree, and to be honest, I get fucking lost and dizzy trying to navigate through it. So you've got your 8 permanent zombies. Then you can also eventually get a golem. There's different kinds. The only one I've found is this chaos golem. And he kind of looks like a spider. He's another permanent minion. Aside from him, you can also get these spirits. And basically, can't really remember how you make them. You must use Raise Spectre. And I think this works on a corpse. Yeah, so you can raise corpses as spectres. And it seems you can only have 2 at a time, or at least I can only have 2 at a time. Maybe if I dig around in the skill tree more, I can find them. But they hang around forever, basically, which is neat. The game has you playing very actively. For example, while your minions are doing everything, you can also spawn these skulls that kind of fly around, hit things and blow up. And you also get even more skulls, like those blue ones, from your equipment. Then there's also various other things you can do, like you have an aura. You can cause contagion, which is kind of like a curse debuff. What else can you do? There's also these offerings you can do. Let's see if I can find the offering. Flesh offering. So basically, there's different kinds of offerings and they do different things, and their strength is increased by how many corpses are around where you cast it. We've got the flesh offering, which makes your minions stronger, and the spirit offering, which grants them a energy shield, which is kind of like a force field that takes damage before your health does. In the skill tree, you can also, if you're a necromancer, get the ability like I have, this one, Mistress of Sacrifice, and this lets you lets these offerings also affect you as well as the minions, which is kind of neat. Let's go and kill some more shit. So as you can see, you've got capable minions. None of this insulting bullshit temporary summons and crap. Like, you do have temporary summons, but you get a decent amount of permanent summons to make it feel worthwhile. But overall, I really like this game, and it's a great option for someone looking for a necromancer in a Diablo 2 style game. Alright, so now let's talk about Din's Curse. You probably haven't heard about this game, it's kind of obscure. It's definitely more of an indie type game. It's an ARPG like Diablo, and it does have necromancy. The problem I have with it is, in my opinion, the necromancy in it isn't very good. And you'll see why. Let's take a look at the necromancy skills first. So you can get skeletons. I don't know what the cap is. I guess it tells me here, max of 4, okay? You can get skeleton archers, which is good. At the moment I've only got a max of 2 of them. And that's it for the summons. Aside from zombie, which you can raise a corpse to be a, you know, a minion. I haven't tried zombie, I've stuck with the skeletons. Now the problem I have with this game is you need a corpse to make a skeleton, which is fine. That's standard. But the problem is once you get it to the point where you're, you know, on a higher difficulty, if you've invested all your points in making minions strong, then when it comes time to actually kill your first enemy so you can make a minion, you're just too weak. So you're kind of gimped. And in my opinion, this basically limits the fun you can have with a minions build in this game. And on top of that, the minions aren't really that great either. I've just got to find some enemies here. When I finally do, I'll show you the minions. But, you know, if you can cope with that, it's not a terrible game. Let's see if I can kill anything here without getting killed myself. This is going to be difficult. Maybe there's something else up here on this level that I can kill. This guy. Alright, so I've got a corpse. And I can make a minion. Great. And you might be noticing how few corpses there are in this level that I've already cleared. Yeah, that's because the corpses only last about 5 or 10 seconds at most. So basically, if you get to the point where you've wiped and you need to replace your minions, you're basically fucked at that point. You have to go down here where the tough enemies are and do your best to try and kill something. Frantically try and raise a minion. Very frantically, because your minions aren't very strong, like one's already died for me. Despite me putting everything, all of my skills into minions. Depressing. Now I'm out of mana, so I go drink, and meanwhile this corpse is gonna despawn. Hopefully I was fast enough that it didn't despawn. So you can see the problem. I'm not even at a super hard difficulty yet, but because I've invested all my points into minions to get the best minions possible, I've kind of gimped my character. Need a dead body. You've got one. Now the cool thing is you can actually get a decent amount of minions. Like, I'm getting a lot of minions here. And they are capable enough, they will kill shit, but they're just not as capable as the minions in the other two games I've shown. And I think I lost my corpse there. Did I reach my maximum already? Yeah, four skeletons. Now I'm gonna have to switch to making archers. My biggest army now, basically. 4 skeletons and 2 bowmen. As you can see now, I'm doing okay, like, it's not too terrible. So it's not like my minions are that great either. I put every sodding point I have into these guys. So while I would say that you can have necromancy in this game and you can have some fun with the necromancy in this game, it's not the best experience. Especially since on high difficulties your entire build is just gimped and you're basically fucked. Aside from that, it's a pretty fun ARPG. If you can handle that indie look. I hope this video has helped you on your quest to find a game that will scratch that necromancer itch. My next video will cover on other genres such as strategy, roguelike, MMORPG, and so on.